welcome to your class. And today, as you know, we have read complete chapter 2, The Address by Marga Amin Coe. And today we are going to discuss question answers. Okay, so for discussing question answers, let me take you people to text so that I can show you the questions, so and we can discuss the answers as well. So let us start. Guys, let us start discussing question answers. Our first question is, have you come back? Said the woman. I thought that no one had come back. Does the statement give some clue about the story? If yes, what is it? So yes, of course, it does give some clue about the story. The statement indicates that the two families knew each other. When the Second World War was going on, the narrator's family, being Jews, left their home to take refuge in places far away to escape. Some people who remained there thought that those people who had left their homes would never come back. That is why the women felt surprised to see one of them back. The narrator and her mother were trusting and loving human beings. Her mother trusted Mrs. Dalrymple and her precious belongings when she fled her home. But Mrs. Dalrymple abused her trust and did not want to return them now. That is why she made this statement. So now the second question is, the story is divided into pre-war and post-war times. What hardships do you think the girl underwent during these times? So let us discuss this question. The narrator has gone through much hardship, as implied or specially mentioned as various places in the chapter. I would like to focus on some of the points here, some of the sentences which the narrator mentioned in the chapter. First, her mother has died, as implied by her statement near the end. Second, afraid of being confronted with these things that had belonged to a connection that no longer existed. Okay, and then she says, but gradually everything became more normal again. Bread was getting to be a lighter color. There was a bed you could sleep in unthreatened, a room with a view you were more used to glancing at each day. Now see, this implies that during the war they were forced to eat bread which was black. They were always afraid of being caught and sent to a concentration camp like other Jews. And they could not even look out of the window as it was covered with blackout paper. She also says near the end, what should I have done with them in a small rented room where the shreds of blackout paper still hung along the windows and no more than a handful of cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawers. See, the sentences which I am just repeating, these have been mentioned in the text. Okay, ye sare ke sare sentences text mein diye hue hain, but I am focusing on those sentences only which are showing the hardship of the girl, hardship of the narrator. Okay, so this means that even after the war, she is living almost in poverty in the same small room in which she sheltered during the war, the window of which were having blackout paper still remaining same. Thus, she has suffered and is still suffering much hardship. Besides being deprived of her rightful possessions of her Mrs. Dalrymple. Okay, although she had a rightful possession of all those things which Mrs. Dalrymple had, but still she was living in poverty. Okay, so all these sentences, which many sentences have been mentioned in the text, bahut sare sentences diye hue jo text mein hai, and those sentences show that the girl was still undergoing hardships. Okay, so now let us discuss the third question.
why did the narrator of the story want to forget the address? Okay, see why she was so connected with her mother, and she initially she wanted the possession of all those sweet belongings, the belongings of those sweet memories. Okay, but still at the end she decides, she resolves not to remember that address again. She wanted to forget that address. So what was the reason behind that? Let us discuss. The narrator went to the house of the lady who had safely kept many valuable items of her mother during the war days. The address of the lady given by her dead mother in those days helped her in searching out the house of the lady. But after finding the belongings of her mother being kept and used in an improper way, she lost all her emotional attachment to them. Everything was arranged in a tasteless way. The ugly furniture and the unpleasant smell evoked the memory of the war again. Okay, now see the unused, the unpleasant way of this furniture and the smell, everything just made her remember the war days, and she became upset. वो दिन उसे याद आ जाते हैं जो war days के थे, कैसे वो कितना सफ़र किया था उन्होंने, और वो सारी सफरिंग याद होने के याद आने के बाद अब उसकी जो sweet memory वाली जो एक feeling थी वो अब lost हो जाती है. Okay, and reminded her again of her dead mother. So she justified her action of not wanting to take the belongings by saying to herself that she lived in a small rented room. She had no place to keep all these things. That's why she wanted to forget that address. Now वो justify कैसे करती है अपने आप को कि मेरे पास तो एक छोटा सा रूम है और मेरे पास ड्रॉर भी नहीं है कटलरी वगैरह रखने के लिए, और उस छोटे से रूम में मैं क्या क्या फिट करूँगी, तो बेटर है कि इस जो है ना इन चीज़ों को, इन बिलोंगिंग्स को यहीं रहने दूँ. वैसे भी ये क्या याद दिलाते हैं मुझे, मेरी मरी हुई माँ की याद दिलाते हैं. सो लेट इट बी योर ओनली. ओके, सो नाउ लेट इस कम टू फोर्थ क्वेश्चन. द एड्रेस इज़ अ स्टोरी ऑफ ह्यूमन प्रेडिकमेंट. ओके, ह्यूमन सफरिंग और आफ्टर द वॉर दैट फॉलोज वॉर. तो वॉर होने के बाद जो ह्यूमन सफरिंग रहती है, वॉर तो हो जाती है, डिस्ट्रक्शन बहुत ज़्यादा होता है. सो आफ्टर दैट व्हाट अबाउट द कंडीशन ऑफ द रेस्ट ऑफ द पीपल, द ह्यूमन बीइंग. तो कितनी सफरिंग होती है वॉर के बाद. ओके, तो उसकी के बारे में बताया गया है, ड्यूरिंग द वॉर और आफ्टर द वॉर कितनी सफरिंग एक कॉमन पर्सन को करनी झेलनी पड़ती है. सो कमेंट. So let us discuss the answer. Marva Minkow's short story, The Address, describes the human predicament that follows war. Okay, so this is the question. So war had caused a big change in the lives of the people of Holland. Holland ke logon ke life mein bahut change ho gaya tha. As they lost their lives and homes, Mrs. S was also a victim of the war. When the narrator, Mrs. S's daughter, went to Mrs. Dalrymple's house to claim those articles with which her mother's precious memories were associated, Mrs. Dalrymple was surprised to see the narrator at her door and even pretended not to recognize her. यहाँ तक कि इतना pretend करने लगी, इतना दिखावा करने लगी कि इसने तो उन्हें पहचाना ही नहीं. Later, the narrator was shocked to see the nice belongings of her mother lying in Mrs. Dalrymple's house. She felt sad, and things appeared to have lost their worth in absence of their true owner. अब जब वो उनको देखती हैं, जब narrator देखती हैं उनकी belongings को जो वहाँ पर पड़ी हुई थी, ओके, वो बहुत उदास हो जाती हैं और उसे ये लगता है कि true owner की absence में शायद इन चीज़ों की जो worth है, जो value है, वो ख़त्म ही हो गई है. She felt sad and things appeared to have lost their worth in the absence of the true owner. Therefore, she decided to leave those things and forget the address forever. Okay, so the story presents the big change in the lives of the narrator and her mother caused by the war. The story shows how war brings a dehumanizing effect on human beings. It kills the feelings of love and sympathy. It makes person cruel and selfish. Ki life jo hai na war se pehle kaisi life thi. Mrs. S, she belonged to a well-to-do family and they had no suffering and they were leading a very happy life. But after the war, unki situation kaisi hogi during the war or after the war, they suffered a lot. Okay, they underwent very much hardship. It was a very hard time for them and इतने बड़े घर में रहने वाले, चांदी की चम्मच से खाने वाले, आप एक छोटे से रूम में रहते हैं और विंडो से बाहर झांक भी नहीं सकते हैं, एंड दैट वॉज ओनली टू सेव देयर लाइव्स. सो गाइज, ओनली 4 क्वेश्चंस वर गिवन आफ्टर द चैप्टर एंड दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट टुडे. सो थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.
सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. And now if you have any problem, if you have queries, then you can ask your queries in your comment box. The answers will be given as soon as possible. If still the things are not clear to you, you can contact me personally. Thank you. Have a nice day. We'll meet tomorrow.